right, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to make a quick little video on who should you pick on the 110 free multis or like singles or whatever. Like you get 11 or 10 free multis on a side banner, which is actually pretty good. I actually really like it. I believe it's a 7% banner. Yep, right here. It has been increased to 7%. It has 14 characters on it with Holy Knight Escanor. I believe it's Green Escanor. We have one of the Sin of Wrath, Meliodas. We have Holy Knight Diane, Fairy King, Holy Knight Gother, which I believe is probably Red Gother. He's not Green Gother. Merlin, Bond, Princess Elizabeth, Queen Roxy, Player Shin, Camilla, Malascula, Droll, and Esterosa. So those aren't the best units. They're basically just in there for coins, honestly. And thankfully, it's 7% rate up. So, you know, you have a pretty good chance. I pulled SSR almost every single multi, probably about 5 or 6 times, which is pretty darn good. But now the main question is, who should you guys pick at the guaranteed multis? Because about every 4 multis, because of how they put it, you will get a guaranteed character. So at 4 multis, you'll get the 100. At 6 multis, you'll get the 200. Because of how it goes, it'll be 120 and then 210. Yeah, you guys get it. So in my opinion, it kind of depends what you guys need help clearing. Because the first ones, Derrieri isn't even that great for Knighthood boss anymore, mainly just for Crimson Demon. She's been replaced by Ludo Margot or Purgatory Bond, unless you're trying to get to the top like 0.1%. But in my opinion, I would kind of go with Zaratross for the first like pick, because he clears Belmos really easily, probably the best unit in the game for that. And then he can also just, you know, clear any final boss, like the final boss Diane. There's a final boss Diane coming, and Zaratross is pretty much needed in order to beat it. Like it makes it way easier from what I've seen. So keep that in mind. There will be a super final boss Diane coming probably next week after the Gother, but I could be wrong. And then we have Danifor Liz, Red Easton, and Tank Diane. Now all of these units are actually really good. Danifor Liz being for a great demon. For Belmos, Red Easton being for the Purgatory Bond team, and I think that's pretty much her only use. I don't think I've seen her anywhere else. And then, of course, we have Green Tank Diane, which is a very solid unit in PvP, unless you face a Bond, and probably a new Fest Gother as well. She would probably get cucked, yeah, because it blocks out taunts or any buff cards, so that really sucked. But she's also good against a bird if you don't want to get Matrona. But Matrona is apparently better than Diane, so there is that. So for this one, I would highly pick either Liz or Diane, depending on your situation. If you already have a Liz, I would say go for a Diane. If you don't have a Liz, I would say pick Liz. But if you don't have either of them, I would say probably Liz, because you don't need a Holy Relic to improve in the game. But what you do need is Grey Demon mats and Belmos mats, so I would highly suggest getting that. And plus, she's much more niche to get, unlike Diane, where she's in the part 2 banner. She's on a bunch of other banners as well quite a bit. So yeah, that's just my 2 cents on it. And now the final pick, it's kind of just whoever you prefer, because I mean, I guess OG Ludo has a really good passive in terms of like his grace, where you can not get stunned or frozen or anything for 2 turns, especially if you put him underneath as an association link. MK2 is just really fun. She's probably one of my favorite units in the game. That is why I picked her on my JP. I didn't really care for Ludo that much, and I don't like blue Lost Vein whatsoever. Now, if you want to have a high ult Lost Vein and you just have a bunch of dupes on a blue Lost Vein and no red Lost Vein, you might want to pick him, but he just hits so soft compared to the red Lost Vein. I don't know. So that's why I didn't really like him. And so I chose green MK2. But on my global, I'm going to be picking blue Lost Vein because the other two are already 6-6. So it kind of just depends who do you want a 6-6. Do you want to have a 6-6 MK2, which is really fun, especially when blue units are in the meta. She absolutely slaps booty cheeks. Like, she just destroys, and they just go ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Or you can pick Ludo for a really nice link. I mean, he has good CC, and if you run CC food with HP defense, you will out CC most units in the game. And then there's Blue Lost Fane, which literally nobody runs. Like, every once in a while I've seen him, but it's like maybe once a month. So I kind of think you should just use either Ludo or MK2 for fun. Probably leaning more towards Ludo. So I guess I'll recap. I would highly suggest picking Zoroastrius, Danafort Liz, and then Ludo as your main three picks. So, yeah, tell me down below, guys, what do you guys think? Who are you picking? Hopefully you guys pull some SSRs, even if you already have them 6-6. Hopefully, you know, you just get some coins, because everybody's in some dire need of some SA coins at this point. I know I am. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that like button, and come join my live stream in a few hours. I guess it's going to be about 13 hours, 11 p.m. CST time. So, stay tuned, and I'm going to be 6-6ing Festival Gother. Peace out and take care.